You're about to see and discover everything you need to know about Holland America New Staten Dam cruise ship. Hi, I'm Gary Bemidge, and this is another of my tips for travelers. This is the sixth ship within the Holland America fleet to have Staten Dam in its name. The first dates right back to 1898. Well, at the time of recording, there were 14 ships in the Holland America fleet, and this is the second of the three pinnacle class ships. So the pinnacle class is a new range of ships which was brought out by Holland America, and the first was the Koningsdam, the second is the new Staten Dam. The third pinnacle class ship will come into service in 2021. The layout of the ship and the look of the ship is very similar to the Koningsdam. It holds 2,666 guests in 1,377 staterooms. And the new Staten Dam took its first paying passengers in December 2018. The second thing I want to take you through is what are the innovations and what's new on board. Well, Holland America focuses on three key things. They focus on exploration and excursions and destinations, food, and very importantly, they focus on music. One of the big innovations is the music walk. So the music walk consists of, first of all, the Lincoln Center stage. This is where you have classical concerts and various classical recitals. Now, Lincoln Center stage is held in the same venue as B.B. King's Blues Club. B.B. King's Blues Club is one of the most popular of all of the music venues, and you have a nine-piece band, and they perform incredible music a number of times during the course of the evening. A little bit further along on the ship are two other venues, one of which is the Billboard on Board. So Billboard on Board has two pianists, and they will run during the course of the evening various shows, which might be British Invasion or One Hit Wonders or request shows. Then opposite that is the new addition, which appeared for the first time on New Staten Dam, which is the Rolling Stone Rock Room. And this is a phenomenal new venue where, not surprisingly, they play rock music. All of those partners, they screen and vet the musicians before they come on board. So each of them are very much linked to their original host. Further along from this is the World Stage. This is an amazing venue, so it's almost in the round. And what Holland America have done on New Staten Dam is move that focus more into music. So instead of having the more traditional production shows, they have a lot of guest artists. So for example, on the cruise I was on, they had the Spanish Rumba Kings, they had an opera singer, and all of the shows are now related to music and dance. So after music, the other thing that they focus on is exploring and destinations. And like some of the other Holland America ships, up on the Crow's Nest is EXE, Exploration Central, where you have the shore excursions desk and these very innovative interactive screens where you can go, you can flick through the various ports of call, you can then look at maps, you can get various information. Also up there, by the way, is also the Explorations Cafe, which is a partnership with the New York Times. So let's take a look at the dining options. Well, first of all, you have the main dining room, which I really love the look of this. It just felt very different. And of course, this is where you can have breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They have fixed seated dining in the evenings, although you can also have anytime dining. Of course, one of the most popular things on board cruise ships, and I really liked it on New Staten Dam, which is the Lido Market. So this is the buffet restaurant. What I liked about it, they now have various stations which focus on different things. So breakfast, you'll have one station which is perhaps the healthy options or the bread and pastries options or where they cook you omelets. So then the stations, of course, adapt based on lunch and dinner. Two other venues that are included within the fare is Dive In. Dive In is on the pool deck. It's the burger hot dog restaurant. Really good burgers. I really liked it here. Very, very popular, particularly at lunchtime. The other venue is the New York Deli and Pizza. Fantastic pizzas where you can either order off menu or you can create your own and decide what toppings you want. Another venue that's free for food is the Grand Dutch Cafe. This is a really popular meeting point. Now you do have to pay for the specialty teas and coffees at the Grand Dutch Cafe. If you want free tea and coffee, you just go up to the Lido Market up on deck 9. So that's the food that's included within your fare. So what are the specialty dining options? So you have the Pinnacle Grill, which is the steakhouse. Now what's great on New Staten Dam is Rudy's Salle de Mer. So this is the more seafood based restaurant. And this now has its own venue. So on some of the ships, it becomes a pop-up restaurant on some evenings. But on New Staten Dam, it's its own restaurant. Incredible seafood. Now, my favorite specialty restaurant is Tamarin. Tamarin is a Pan-Asian sort of fusion restaurant with incredible food. Now, what's great on New Staten Dam, they now have a standalone sushi bar, which is a la carte, called Nami Sushi. If you like Italian, they have Canaletto. This operates in the evening, and it's actually a subset or a little section of the Lido Market. Then the evening becomes Canaletto. A new dining venue was first introduced on board New Statendam, and this is called Club Orange. Club Orange is a place where people in suites or anybody can then pay to become a Club Orange member. And it costs, at the time of recording, $50 per person per day. There's a whole lot of other amenities built into that, but you can then eat your meals in Club Orange. It has an adapted menu from the main dining room, and they do have some special dishes which are only served in Club Orange. Another very popular spot is the gelato station, which is on the pool deck. There you can buy either gelato or you can buy little popsicles made of gelato. Because of the focus on food, another feature on New Statendam, like many of the 100 America ships, is America's Test Kitchen. And this is where they have cooking demonstrations. So let's talk about accommodation, the range of options that you've got on the New Statendam. Now, as I mentioned earlier, it holds 2,666 guests in 1,377 staterooms. You do have some solo cabins, and then you have a range from inside cabins through to big palatial suites. So let's start, first of all, with an inside cabin. So here's an example of an inside cabin, pretty decent size. The other great thing they've introduced are family suites. So this is an example of a family suite. You can actually hold five people. So you have a double bed, you have a double sofa bed, and there's actually another bed which comes out of the roof. They have two bathrooms. You have one bathroom area which has a bath in. So if you've got young kids, you've got a bath. Another one which has a shower area. And so you can actually be bathing and showering at the same time. So you can actually get, you know, ready and out much quicker. In terms of numbers, the main class of cabin are veranda cabins or balcony cabins. These are a pretty good size, actually. Many of them will have a sofa bed, you have the desk area, and you have a bathroom. Now, the bathroom I also really liked. It has a nice big shower area, which is, I guess, almost the size of a bath, and Elemis toiletries, so pretty premium. After veranda staterooms, you start going into suites. And I'm going to show you three examples of suites. The first of all is the Vista Suite. So here is an example of a Vista Suite. So this, I guess, is really the entry level into suites. And again, it's a great sized room. You then have a signature suite. Signature suites are one of the more popular types of suites. And here's an example of what a signature suite looks like. And again, as I mentioned, these have showers, not baths. If you want to go up to the next level, you have a Neptune suite. And again, these are pretty popular and they are spread around the ship. This is a much bigger suite, and this is probably one of my favorite types of suites. Then above that, you have the big suites, which unfortunately I didn't get to see, which is the more sort of owner suite. So what about fitness and recreation? In terms of swimming pools, there's two, first of which is the Lido pool, which is in the center of deck 9. This also has a roof which can cover over, so if the weather's not great, the roof can be covered over and you can swim all year round. And this is also where they'll have movies in the evening on the big screen. On the back of deck 9, you have the sea view pool, which is much more open. So particularly if you're in nice warm climates, it's a great place to be out. If you do want some peace and quiet, one of the things that you can do is you can pay to go to the retreat. This is a very beautiful area. It's very private. It's very secluded. It's very exclusive. One of the things I really liked about this ship, like all Holland America ships, is it has a promenade deck that goes the entire way around. If you walk around it three times, you do a mile. And a lot of people will do that walk, particularly on sea day. If you want to do something a bit more active, up on deck 11, you've got a running track and you've also got a sports court where you can play things like basketball. Of course, there is the greenhouse spa and the fitness center, which is a good, decent size with a good wide range of equipment. And also they do have exercise class where they can do things like spinning. So what about entertainment and activities and other things to do? Now, of course, you'll have a daily program, which will have a wide range of activities from quizzes, competitions, deck games, all that kind of stuff. They have a casino. It's a pretty big casino. So at the time of recording, you could still smoke in the casino, which is not something that I'm a big fan of. You have a whole range of shops, which sell everything, of course, from branded merchandise, jewelry, perfume, alcohol, the usual stuff you'll find. Pretty big shop area. There's quite a big art gallery where you can obviously buy artwork. The other thing that's very interesting across the whole ship is the huge range of artwork. So the decor and the look and the feel of the ship is quite traditional. It's quite refined, but the artwork is much more quirky and there's some really interesting pieces. Like other Holland America ships, they have a partnership with Microsoft and they have a very large digital workshop. If you're traveling with children or teenagers, there is Club Howl. There are three separate clubs, from the very young ones, the sort of tweeny ones up until about 12, 13, and then there's the teenagers one up till the age of 16, 17 years old. There's also, of course, the Photoshop. It's a partnership with Fuji Films. And what's great about it now is you can also take your own photographs that you might have taken on your iPhone or on your camera. You can go there and you can also then create your own product. The next thing I want to talk about are bars and lounges. There's Blend, which is an area where you can learn about wine and you can actually learn how to blend your own wines. Linked to that, there's also a place called Notes, which has a huge selection of whiskies. And again, they have different whiskey tasting events. Another popular place to meet before meals is the Ocean Bar, which is sort of on the way to the dining room, or it's near Rue du Seldemeyer, near the Pinnacle Grill. Then, of course, at the pools, you have the Lido Pool and the Sea View Pool Bars. But most of the bars are really linked to the Music Walk venues. The Pinnacle Class is the new generation of Holland America ships, which are redesigned to provide a much more modern cruising experience. As I've shown you on the new Staten Dam, there's quite a lot of introductions and new things that have been introduced for the very first time. The overall look of the ship, it's a really interesting mix between sort of a traditional feel and a modern feel. And so although some of the decor is sort of more traditional, the artwork is very funky and different, so it has quite a nice mix to it. I'd love it if you watched many more of my Tips for Travelers videos, because you'll get much more inspiration, advice and tips on how to make so much more of your very precious travel time and money, whether it's on land or at sea.